cap, H, E, L, L, O, exclamation mark, grinning face with smiling eyes, and sweat drop.
Today we're going to explore two newer features of iOS 18, the hover typing and the keyboard feedback. Let's do it. Hi everyone, welcome to Carry On Accessibility, where we talk about tech and accessibility. Typing on a touchscreen when you're low vision, especially when you're not using a screen reader, can be a bit challenging, but hover typing and keyboard feedback do make it a lot easier, especially on the iPhone for me. So let's check out how to turn these on and how to use these. So here I have the iPhone 16 Pro Max, and we're going to go to accessibility settings. You can use Siri or just go to settings and navigate down to accessibility. Open accessibility settings. Now scroll down to the accessories heading and go to keyboard and typing. Keyboards and typing. We're going to tap there. And the first option is hover typing. The second option is typing feedback. So first of all, just take a look at typing feedback, actually. The first setting is character. You can have it announce the characters as you type them, and you can turn on character hints. If you don't want the character hints right away, you can increase or decrease the amount of time before the character hints are announced. You can have it speak words, so we'll turn that one on. There's also speak auto text and hold to speak prediction. You can tap and hold on a prediction above your keyboard and it's supposed to read it to you. I personally don't like text prediction, so I always have that off. So here is a blank email. We're in the edit field and I can just go ahead and start typing.
Cap, H, E, L, L, O.
Yep, that's all muscle memory. I can't see the keyboard. We can press enter. It does not say that it's a new line though, which I wish it did. And it does not announce when you press backspace, which I really wish that it would tell me what characters are being deleted.
Cap, H, O, W, how, A, R, E, R, Y, O, U.
I wish that I can tap and hold on the characters of the keyboard, especially when it comes to symbol, so that I can find a particular symbol without voiceover necessarily, because I don't know where the question mark is. Well, I kind of do, but I want to make sure before I lift my finger, and it would be really cool if we could tap and hold and kind of drag around even without voiceover. That would be really neat. Apparently, it also does not announce when you type a question mark. It only announces the word, so that was very confusing. If you turn off words, it will
space.
Announce when you press space,
new line.
Announce when you're going on a new line, and it will announce when you're typing symbols. One really cool thing that I really like is that it can announce emojis once you type them.
Grinning face. Grinning face with squinting eye. Face rolling on the floor laughing. Upside down face. Smiling face with smiling eyes. Grinning face with smiling eyes.
So that's what typing feedback is like. Back in the accessibility settings under keyboards and typing, the first option is hover typing, and we'll turn that on. And if we go back to our, well, it's not blank anymore, but our email that we're working on, if I start typing, there is a large box here that comes up right above the keyboard, and we can see the text much larger than normal. In the email app, the text is a bit optimized. This will, I feel, really, really help when you're in other apps that may not have dynamic text sizing or web pages, things like that.
E-L-F-O-G-I G-O-O-D space M-O-R-N I-N-G.
Now let's go back to the settings and see what we can change. We can change the display mode. Right now I have it docked to keyboard, so it's right above the keyboard, but there's also two more options, top and inline. So if we select top, now if we start typing,
H-E-L-L-O.
I really like typing hello. Now the box for hover typing is at the top of the screen. If we go and change that to inline, and we go back to the email,
cap, H-E-L-L-O.
In this case, it is still at the top. I'm really not sure exactly what inline means, if this is supposed to be different, but in my limited experience, it is just staying at the top, so I'm not really sure the difference between top and inline. Now if we go back, the next option down is font. So we can choose from a great variety of fonts here. There are so many. Wow, you can even choose like a really scripty font. I'm not sure why, but that looks really pretty, I guess. Wow, I cannot read that. Let's go back. We'll pick this one. It looks bold. All right. The next option is for size. I already had it at the largest size, but you can definitely adjust the hover typing here. But you can definitely adjust it to the size that you would like. Next we have text color, insertion point color, background color, and border color. And we can customize these to pretty much any color that you would like. Seems pretty awesome. And the last two options is misspelled word color and auto corrected word color. So you can also select your customized colors for those. At the very bottom of this menu, there's a reset to default, so in case you just want to go back to how it was and maybe you changed the colors too much or something, and this sounds like something that I would do, you can reset it easily just by tapping that. I think these are awesome features, and it definitely makes typing a lot easier. Again, I just really wish that it could announce what you're deleting. That's probably my number one ask for the typing feedback. But let me know, are you using these features on your iPhone? Do you find them helpful? Leave them in the comments below. If you liked this video and found it helpful, give it a thumbs up below. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to support the channel and what I do, consider becoming a KOA member on Patreon or YouTube. You get exclusive videos, a monthly meetup, and more. Thanks everybody for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.